So, I was doing this video for Maximo, which is in our current 12 days of Christmas, and depending on when you see this, it might still be on sale. But that's not what this video is about. While doing a little score for it, I stumbled upon this trick where I was like, oh, this might be useful for people. Although if you work with Logic, you might already know this. So what I did, and what is very handy, I think, for instruments like these, but also any other things where you have chords or progressions or melodies that you want to have play across multiple instruments, is when you make aliases of your track. So I played in the chords, and then I just made an alias by using Shift Option Drag, and this alias goes on through all the various tracks, the brass, the strings, and the woodwinds has one. And then I also made an alias of the key switches because they are used a lot in our sonokinetic instruments. For instance, to turn off like the track solos for the various instruments. Like here at the end, you have this bit where it's going to build up, and you see the sections coming in there. And it's quite handy to just have all the key switches there, and if you want to then bring in a section, you can just adjust the note velocity for that one, and then it's on or it's off. Of course, you would have to know which one is which, but I mean that's quite quick to find out. These are the strings ones, and then you can see it here also. So that's one of the tricks. The other trick is to have. And this is something Logic does, and I think most DAWs will do it. But you can make a track, say other, and then do next new track with the same instrument. So all these four tracks, they just send to this same instrument. But in this way, you can have your chords separate from your key switches, from your controller data, which is a lot easier if you want to change just a key switch. You know, you don't have to go looking around like, oh, which one is this? You just go to your track with your key switches, MIDI data, and then you change it there. So the good thing about the alias is that when I change something in the main one here, so for instance, this second chord, I change it. And it just instantly changes it for all three of the sections because of the alias. So now, if for instance, in the strings, I want to have some different chords, I can do it in various ways. But one of the ways is to use our harmonic shift, where you transpose part of it. So the ones where this plus minus thingy is on, which in this case is just the top one, you will transpose those to different chords in the scale, and that's relative. So this C here means that it just plays the main chord, but then if you go to D, it plays, you know, the second chord in that scale. So the way this works is, for instance, like this. So now it goes up in the strings and not in the rest. So that's one way of doing it. Another way would be to, you know, once you're happy with most of your track, to just make an edit here in this one. And as soon as you edit something, this is no longer an alias, and then you can just move things around just for the strings that then have no effect on the other sections. But then you lose this link to the main chords. So that's the two things. So aliases and other new track with same instrument. Let us know in the comments whether this was useful or whether you want us to do more material like this. I sort of like it. You know, I was doing this demo and I was like, yeah, this might be useful to some people, you know. Also, this deal is still on, probably, if you see this today, because tomorrow there's another deal, 12 days of Christmas. Anyway, talk later.